Welcome po to the Environmental Research and Laboratory Services Division of the EMB Central Office. So we are one of the divisions po that supports the EMB in terms of providing research and laboratory support services as required po in the implementation of our environmental laws. So for this time, I will be introducing you with the capabilities of the EMB Central Lab in terms of complementing the implementation of the Philippine Clean Air Act or RA 8749. But before that, mabanggit ko lang din po that the ERLSD has two sections. The first one is the Environmental Research section, which primarily caters to research activities and spearheads the conduct of the same. And then kami po sa Environmental Laboratory Services section naman yung in charge of performing the laboratory support services and review and endorsement of approved methods of analysis for environmental testing. So the Environmental Laboratory Services section po of the ERLSD is in charge of supervising the and managing the operation of the EMB Central Office Laboratory. In case of ambient air testing, we can perform analysis of particulate matter po in air like TSP, total suspended particulates, PM10 and PM2.5 respectively. We also perform tests for gases like sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, and ozone, as well as heavy metal constituents in ambient air samples. For stationary source emissions naman po, we also perform analysis of metals and then gases such as sulfur oxides as SO2 or sulfur dioxide, and then nitrogen oxides or yung atin pong NOx, and of course particulate matter from stationary source emissions. On top of that, we also provide laboratory support services po sa ating acid deposition monitoring project, where we analyze anions and cations, conductivity, pH, total organic carbon, etc. So, ito po yung ating mga capabilities, no, for inorganic contaminants and the constituents po in air samples. Nandito po tayo ngayon sa organics laboratory, in particular the high-level dioxins and furans extraction laboratory, where we perform dioxins and furans analysis in air samples, particularly high-level air samples such as stationary source emissions. So, check po natin kung ano yung mga ginagawa natin sa loob. Pagdating po ng samples dito, no, as I mentioned, pwedeng dalawang klase ng sample pagdating sa air testing ng dioxins and furans. So we have stationary source emissions, kagaya po nito. So the sample is trapped in resin material na nakalagay po sa ganitong cartridge which we prepare, including the filters and then the rinsings from the sampling drain. Kung ambient air naman po yung sample, we have polyurethane foam na naka-assemble po siya ng ganito. We also prepare this beforehand ng sampling, and then the quartz fiber filter. So ganito po siya dadating dito sa laboratory, and the first step really is to extract the dioxins and furans from these samples. So basically we categorize the samples into high-level samples like sa stack gas, and then low-level samples po pag ambient air. So separate lab rooms po yon because we prevent cross-contamination in between these samples. So the first step po is to cut the foam and the filters, and then for ambient air, and then we use soxhlet extraction, manual soxhlet extraction, to extract the dioxins from the sample. And then after po nun, we will do concentration ng samples or ng extract para po mas ma-detect natin yung analytes. So from relatively large volume, pabababain po natin yon into roughly 10 ml. And then magpo-proceed po tayo dun sa next steps. Okay po, so after po ng extraction, no, mabanggit ko lang din, aside from manual soxhlet, we also have capability for pressurized fluid extraction and automated soxhlet extraction. Depende na lang po sa sample kung paano namin i-determine yung extraction procedure. And then after po nun, the extracts, once na-concentrate na po, no, napababa natin yung volume to 10 ml or less, magsasubject po tayo ng cleanup procedures. So the cleanup procedure will vary depending on the expected contaminants ng sample aside from dioxins and furans na target po natin. So we use manual column cleanups. We also have cartridge cleanup procedures na pwede po natin gamitin. Ano? Depende na po sa kung ano yung nakikita natin na suited for the interferences. And then after po nun, i-concentrate po ulit natin yung extracts to lesser volume using the rotary evaporators. And then after that, we proceed with micro-evaporation kagaya po ng ginagawa natin dito where the extracts from the last container is transferred into conical tubes. And then ito na po yung vessels natin for the micro-evaporation. So the key here really is sa dami po ng steps na pinagdadaanan is to ensure na properly rinse po yung mga containers in every step para makuha po natin yung initial natin na extracts more or less or contents niya papunta dun sa mga pinagsasalinan. And then we do nitrogen blowdown micro-evaporation. So gumagamit po tayo ng inert gas to reduce the volume to roughly 1 ml, and then kung kaya pa po natin i-concentrate since dioxins po ito mas trace po kasi ang kanilang concentration, so we even go down to up to 50 or 20 microliters na lang po. And then the final sample is contained in vials po na kagaya nito, and then ito na po yung final product. Ready na po ito for instrumental analysis where doon na po natin malalaman kung ano yung concentration ng dioxins and furans or other organic pollutants po na tinatest natin. So, after nung pinagdaanan po ng steps ng samples from extraction, concentration, then cleanup, and then final microevaporation, dito na po siya i-release sa gas chromatograph with high-resolution mass spectrometer. So, ito po yung gas chromatograph na part where the separation of the components happen, and then ito po yung ating detector na magnetic sector line mass spectrometer. So, this is a first of its kind po dito sa Pilipinas since we are, so far at this time, the only laboratory that performs dioxins and furans testing in the Philippines. So, dito po natin nalalaman kung ano yung concentration ng target po natin na dioxins and furans na constituents po ng sample, kung meron man po, no, through injection po ng sample extracts into this instrument. And then after po na, we process the data using our computers and the software, and then we determine the final concentration na lalabas po doon sa ating test report. Okay po, so in all those cases po no, na pinakita nating testing activities, the results are provided to our clients no, directly by the ERLSD. And these results may serve for purposes of compliance monitoring, enforcement, and then for research and development, as well as policy formulation activities, no, kagaya po ng ginagawa namin sa EMB. And also, the ERLSD po through our section implements the Environmental Laboratory Recognition Scheme of the DENR. So, if you happen to have any testing needs for specific ambient air or stationary source emission parameters, pwede nyo pong i-visit yung aming website where makikita ninyo po yung list ng DENR-recognized labs nationwide which we update regularly.